Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian special forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country?
I flew in business class from Manaus.
Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
You should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pakatari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers. This is the help you promised? That Sandoval promised? A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pakatari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru's one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, our group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he is in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pakatari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Hoo-ah.
go.
Got enemy activity nearby.
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Yo, we got hostiles.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move. Deploying drone. Target carrying submachine guns. Just spotted one with submachine guns.
move into position. Ready to fire. Got him, he's down. Heads up, hostile presence.
Spotting another tango.
Ay, mi gordita. Estas nuevas panchoncitas.
Okay, we're cool. Eyes on a narco with a submachine gun near that sandbag emplacement.
Coopere, todo saldrá bien.
Pinche cabrón.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón! What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move.
Okay, we're still good.
Let's get moving. The cartel isn't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru. Got another tango, and baby makes three.
Roger that. Move it. Say the word, boss. Go not.
chingues esos putos!
We're clear over here. Jesus, he wasn't a threat, you know? Enemy activity, stay sharp.
These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
We're good to go.
Sueño, the sicarios have found the escaped prisoner in the village of Culta.
What a wonderful name for a town. They were protecting him?
Si. The village is known to Unidad as a haven for rebels.
Why do these rebels even bother? Kill them all. The whole village. Visit divine wrath upon Culta, and wipe it off the face of the earth.
Claro. Al rato.
Buckle up, people.
Such a great thing. This could have been avoided if we had been looking out for each other. You may not have met him, but you all know Ricky Sandoval.
Drone is airborne.
Huh.
see a second target. Tango number 3. Here's target number 5.
I got a Sicario over here.
Tell me where.
Inside the barn. Take a look. Assholes, no worries. Stay quiet. Oh, fuck. They're heading this way. They're on a wild goose chase now. We done? Shit, kind of got all excited there. Toyo Farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go. Hold up. There's a weapons case here. I've been wanting one of these.
Si son extranjeros, les debemos la vida a estos güeros.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
There are a lot of lights and switches up here.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor. Check it out, weapons case.
Ah, I can use this. Mm-hmm.
hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through. That's the rundown.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency, and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchon named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itacua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
¿Cómo va?
Hang on, I'll drive.
Eventually, I tried to exploit that element for the viewing audience.
So, in other words, to you're sick fucks.
Hit that, see, bro.
GPS says the place is named Yopil.
I don't see any signs of fighting. It's just a ghost town.
I suppose either the cartel or the dogs chased everybody off.
Nomad, I've got Pacatari on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Put him through.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itacua, and Bowman says you may be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri and Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Atari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel supply convoy passing through the province soon. Capturing it would give my people much-needed supplies and restore their morale. Can you do this?
Consider it done.
We're taking orders from Pat Atari now?
Atari needs this convoy. We are gonna give it to him. The more he depends on us to get shit done, the more we can get out of him in return.
Takatari's rebel movement is on the verge of defeat. If we help him turn things around, we'll be able to count on his support in the future.
A boy once asked me, what makes a good sicario? The question gave me pause. We do not recruit sicarios through job listings in the newspaper. We recruit the people we know. Amigos from the calle, those we might meet in prison. And we may see something in these hombres that we like, something that has potential. But the boy who asked the question, what makes a good sicario, was asking because he wanted to know who he should be, who he should become. There are many qualities that a good sicario must try to have. Cojones, strength, good aim with a rifle, cunning. Very few men in this world have all these gifts, but in truth, a man needs none of them to be a good sicario. The only thing discarded, tossed away into the dirt, like the garbage he is.
Execution.
The cartel's sending a message. Here's what happens to rebel sympathizers.
They haven't been up there long. We must have really pissed somebody off on that last op.
Encuentre todo y encuéntrelo al mejor precio solo en Mercab, la cadena de supermercados líder en Bolivia. Si no lo encuentra en Mercab, no lo encuentra en Bolivia.
Las mentes cerradas. The small-minded will tell you that Santa Muerte is a dark relic, morbid and dangerous. I say that ordinary morality is for children and simpletons. An attraction to death has long been one of mankind's great taboos, and taboos are made to be broken. Why else do we gorge ourselves on holidays? Why are carnivals and the feast days of saints? Santa Muerte is a dark but central angel of death. And that representation of death affirms life. And life, real life. Not that habit of modern living. But la verdadera vida trembles with the force of the greatest thunderstorm, with the violence of the oceans. This is the experience that Santa Muerte embodies. Come to us and learn more about her. Come venerate her, adorarla y amarla. She will help you become the greatest person you could possibly be. Do not accept your life as it is. Become more. May Santa Muerte bless you. Amen. How can you be victorious in a spiritual battle if you do not believe in it? Think on faith within the heart of every man, the good, the generous. The brave half of his heart struggles against the evil. The selfish, the cowardly half. Whether or not you are aware of it, whether or not you believe in the spiritual battle, those around you can see which side is winning, can feel if it is the good or the evil that wins. Accept the reality of this battle, hermanos. Cultivate the good and benevolent half of your heart so that it will conquer the evil. But keep that evil half alive, just as God gave Lucifer his own kingdom. Let your evil reign in its prison, because you never know when you will need your heart to be ruthless.
Thank you.
Ready? Fire, fire, fire.
We'll go.
Engaging hostiles. Lieutenant's trying to escape. Combo gear's in good shape. Pass on the location of the truck to the rebels. Eyes up. We've got Unidad vehicles on the road. Looks like a standard patrol plus a combo truck.
Qatar's people would like to get their hands on those radios. What do you think, boss?
Pack, this is Nomad. The convoy is secure.
Gracias, amigo. My people will make good use of those supplies. My people are searching for La Yuri y El Polito, but in the meantime, there is something else you can do for us. I have prepared a speech for the people of Bolivia. It is a call to arms that we will broadcast from Itacua.
Santa Blanca is going to send troops to shut that down as soon as they hear the transmission.
You see my problem? I need someone dependable to find a radio transmitter and protect it until the broadcast is complete.
Okay, Qatari. We'll get it done. Out of the car. Now. Don't make this harder than it has to be.
Go on without
me. Let's
go.
Sorry about this, brother, but I gotta have the car. Out.
No. Then it was the other niños at school. As I got older, it was boyfriends, co-workers, and let's be honest, my mother has never stopped calling me Mandona. People say it's because they expect a woman to be pleasant and sweet. O sea, there are even some women out there, successful women, who want to ban the actual word bossy. But people who are satisfied being pleasant, don't act bossy, even if they don't like the word, they don't get what they fucking want. They don't make millions of dollars a month shipping products all over the world. They don't have a hacienda or hundreds of sicarios ready to die for them. So chicas, be mandonas, be bossy. If you're una cohibida and you're not una cabrona, you won't ever be the fucking boss.
Santa Blanca came to Bolivia, and we made this country our home. But now is the time to look for the next journey. We must take risks, strive for new horizons, seek adventure, be the pioneer. It is within our nature to search for the next challenge. We dominate South America's drug trade with our medicina flooding the streets of Sao Paulo, of Rio. And what comes next? How does Santa Blanca grow and expand? We must reach a new customer. We must set our sights on the opposite side of the world, Asia. We will take our cocaine to the Far East. As the Asian economy has grown, as trade agreements between countries have opened up, opportunities for Santa Blanca have appeared. Many of our amigos in Mexico have already begun to take advantage of this new situation. Benefit from these relationships. The future of Santa Blanca is before.
Mm-hmm.